Time to start working on the next part of the shop drawing process for this project. And that'll be adding some cross sections of these products. Now we have our plan and elevation view, but now we need to include some additional details. So this video is going to go through more ways of working with section drawings and how to add some of those details that'll help clearly show our customer what they're going to be getting. So let's open up our project and get into more training. So in our last video, we finished up our sheet by adding these viewports. So now these are ready to go. Still got to do a little bit of work to make sure that we have our view label in the correct position. We'll come back to that in a second. Now we're not going to show all these cross sections on our drawings, but I'm just going to go through a couple different processes that we can use to create some additional details. So let's start off by drawing cross section of our sink cabinet and the upper above. Back into our 2D drawing tools, we're going to draw product sections. Start off with our base cabinet, and we're just going to adjust the distance in X. So let's just enter a 6 there. So this will be 6 inches in from the left-hand side of that cabinet. And now for the upper. Give it the same cutting plane, 6 inches in from its X origin. Now, if that's not the section drawing that you want and you want to add a new one, just delete the 2D drawing, just using the AutoCAD delete command. Since it's just the 2D object we want to get rid of. Draw that cross section again. And this time we're going to leave it at 16 3/4. So that's splitting it almost directly in the center of the cabinet. You can see now it's not showing the cutout for the glass, but we are showing the full door. The dimensions and the other text that we're seeing here on this drawing is coming in from our 2D drawing tokens. So let's go into part properties and take a look at where these drawing tokens are. This first folder is our 2D instructions subassembly, and this is where all the 2D drawing tokens are living for just the carcass. Now, as we get into that subassembly, we now select our prompts tab, selecting on our cross section, and those are the different draw lines representing the floor, representing the wall, and then of course our draw dim tokens that you see down here. These ones are currently not on, and that's because of this formula down here. This formula will understand what kind of cabinet it is and if it needs to have that drawing token on or not. You can see here, this is a toe kick. So with an upper cabinet, obviously there's no toe kick, so that's why that token is off. You can also access these same drawing tokens from Edit Design Data. There's our 2D instructions, subassembly, and then now into the prompts. Scrolling over, we can find our 2D drawing token instructions. There's the plan view, elevation view, and our cross section. Same thing that we were looking at in part properties, just in this spreadsheet format. Now, because we want to use these on our shop drawings, I'm going to add a little bit more detail. Before we do that, I want to go through a couple of the other ways that we can draw cross sections. First one we did was just selecting on the actual product. This time we're going to draw a section of the wall. By doing it this way, we're going to get the products that are associated to that wall drawn at the same time. So if I were just to select the 3D wall itself, we're prompted the same way we are when we select an actual product. Now doing it this way, we're going to have to give it a dimension in X from that product origin. But if we wanted to cut at a specific cabinet, then this won't be the best way to do it. Instead, we're going to want to use pick a cutting plane. But since we don't have a cutting plane to pick, we're going to need to start with that first. So just using a polyline, we can type in PL for polyline. And now when we go back to our draw product sections, we can select our wall, pick the cutting plane, and now pick a point, place that section drawing. So you'll notice there, we have our base cabinet. We also have our countertop because that was also associated to that wall, and with our upper cabinet. Now this rectangle is the column that we had in that corner. So because we have our cabinets facing to the right, we're showing that column. Let's do the same thing. This time we're gonna have the cabinets facing to the left. Now this time we're going to say draw facing left, then pick our cutting plane, and now placing that product section in our drawing. So now we don't see that column obstructing our view. All right, so now it's time to get a section drawing of our tall cabinet. So we're going to select the product again on this one. And the reason for this is because we have these drawing tokens that are included in all these cross-section drawings, right? But we have the option before we draw that cross-section to turn these tokens off in this window here. So let's just see what it looks like when we don't have any of these drawing tokens turned on. So now we can just add our annotations and dimensions that we need through our AutoCAD commands. But that's going to create a lot of extra work. So let's just go back and redraw this with the tokens turned on. Let's do an AutoCAD erase, get rid of that cross section. Again, since it's just a 2D object, it's okay to delete it from the drawing and it won't affect the actual product. So we could go back into the product and just redraw it, but I do want to include this wall. So let's redraw this cross section with the wall and the tokens included. Now I don't have a cutting plane drawn yet, so I'm just going to pull a dimension where I want the section of the tall cabinet. About 6 feet, and we're just going to give ourselves a new origin in X. Make it 72, and we get a section of our tall cabinet. still go back and add any other details. But one other thing that I want to do before we move on to laying these out in our sheets is showing how we can also draw an elevation or a plan view section of these products. If we wanted a plan section, we would just give it the height from the floor where it would cut that cabinet. We're going to do an elevational section because I wanted to point out that you need to have a positive value in the distance in Y from the product origin. Now pick a point to place that elevational section. Okay, so I entered 6 inches and you can see what happened there. We don't have the top of that cabinet. So if we were to pull dimension here, you can see that we need to give at least, I'd say maybe, 10 inches to show that back nailer and the top shelf. So let's go back in, do it again. Just AutoCAD erase, draw product sections. Now we'll just give it a value of 10. If you were to go into the prompts of this product and make any change, we won't do anything. We'll just hit OK and let it redraw. You're going to be asked whether or not you want to redraw your cross-section drawing. You can have it set up to where this will automatically redraw, or you get prompted with these questions. And that's under Toolbox Setup, under the Options tab, AutoCAD, and here we have our drawing preferences. Next to that, you'll see our toolbox section settings where we have prompt to update section, automatically redraw, or never redraw. And when you have it set up like that, you get those windows that ask you if you want to redraw that section or not. Okay, so now let's go into our sheets. So in a previous video, we had these viewports already laid out for us. So now we'll just double click inside of them so we can work with our model space drawing. And I'm going to set my scale. So this is what we want to figure out is at what scale do we need to have this set to so it fits inside of this viewport. Let's try with a 1 inch first. That seems to be the best drawing scale. So once we have that set up, I'd like to lock the viewport. And now we can work inside of this drawing. Even though we're in this sheet, I'm actually accessing model space so we can have some control over these dimensions or annotations. Now we do have that line that I added for a reference point. If we were to do a plot preview, you'll notice that line does show up. So you just set that to a layer that doesn't print. Open up our list of layers here and scroll all the way down. Close to the bottom, we have one called def points. So def points is always a layer that will not print. So anything that you want to have in model space but not show up on your paper space drawings, just make sure that layer is set to def points. You could also have other layers set up to not print. It's just a matter of going into your layer properties manager and turning off plot on any layer that you don't want to show up in paper space. You can also just select the object, right click, go to properties, and change my layer that way. And double clicking outside of that viewport will get us back into paper space. Also, notice down here, paper, model. Another way to change it back and forth. Now for our view label, we have this in paper space. So we just want to reposition this, give ourselves enough room. I'm just using our AutoCAD copy command, moving it over. And if we need to make some adjustments with this 2D drawing, access that viewport again, make sure you unlock your drawing and move it around accordingly. And then of course, to edit these view labels, you can enter ET, edit text, and start entering your new text here. We'll just change the scale to 1 inch equals a foot. So obviously there's a little bit more work that we want to do to clean up this drawing so we can submit it to our customer for approval. One of those things is going to be showing our crown molding that we have for this project. So in our next video, we'll go through a couple different ways that we can add that to our drawing. All right, so that brings us to a good stopping point. We'll call this one done for now and we'll pick it back up in our next video. So until next time, keep practicing and we'll meet back here for some more training.